أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى سيدنا ومولانا محمد. أفضل صلواتك بعدد معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصل عليه. يوم تدعي لا يغني مولا عن مولا شيئا. When a close associate, cordial friend or nearest relative cannot avail from another one anything. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ and no help can they receive. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ اللَّهِ except him on whom Allah has mercy. Except him on whom Allah has mercy. إِلَّهُ بِرِلِي اللَّهِذُ وَالْغَزِيزُ the almighty الرَّحِيمُ and the most merciful. إِلَّا شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُّومِ بِرِلِي the tree of Zakkum. The tree of Zakkum. إن شجرة الزقوم verily the tree of Zakkum طعام لذيذ will be the food of the sinner. And where from this tree would be brought that is grown inside the hellfire. That is grown inside the hellfire. As you know, the trees are of different types. Some trees are called, or plants are called hydrophytes, which is grown inside water, and some other are called xerophyte, which doesn't need any water. If you will water it, it will become dry. You know what I'm saying? So that is a tree not of this world. Otherwise, as you know, that inside a burning fire, no any two of plant will grow. Got it? But in Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that is a tree which is grown there inside a burning fire. Surah As-Saffat. Before ayah number 62, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned his blessings and favor he will give to people in Jannah. So then he asks a question.
أَذَٰلِكَ خَيْرٌ نُزُلًا Is this paradise is better entertainment? أَمْ شَجَرَةُ الزَّقُومِ Are the tree of the poem?
So you can write in bracket a horrible tree inside the burning fire, which is a horrible tree inside the burning fire.
In the shajarata zakkum, verily the tree of zakkum, tu'amul athimi, azalika khairun, نزلًا أم شجرة الزقوم is there paradise is better entertainment or the tree of Zakkum إنا جعلناها indeed we have made it فتنة للظالمين a test and trial for wrongdoers.
So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that there is a tree which is grown inside the burning fire, so Allah says that now their concept is also a trial and test for disbelievers. Because they cannot conceive it. A tree, a plant, that is grown in. This is crazy. They used to say like this, this is crazy. We say that Muhammad is not in sense. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look what he said. Tree, that is grown in help. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that also a different trial for disbelievers. Let them die in that.
They cannot conceive it. للظالمين فاتف بليور إنها شجرة ويرلي تيت ذكري تخرجوا which brings out في أصل الجحيم in the bottom of the hellfire.
Allah made it very much clear.
not to leave any doubt there. Maybe that is grown somewhere outside and only the branches are coming inside. Allah says, no, إِنَّا شَجَرَةٌ تَخْرُجُ فِي أَسْلِ الْجَحِيمِ. That is sprout out right in the bottom of the hellfire. And as you know, that the fruit of a tree which is grown there in a dry desert, that is also by nature that is hot and bitter. Hot and bitter. So now think about the burning hellfire or burning fire in hell, that how hot the fruit of that tree will be and how bitter it will be. Got it?
إِنَّهَا شَجَرَةٌ تَخْرُجُ فِي أَصْلِ الْجَحِيمِ. Verily, this is a tree which springs out of the bottom of hellfire. تَلْقُهَا بِشُوتَ تَيْتَ فُرُوتَ كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُوسُ الشَّيَاطِينِ.
And look, in appearance, its fruits are very ugly. كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُوسُ الشَّيَاطِينِ, like the heads of dogs. Shayateen is the plural of shaitan. Shaitan little meaning is Satan, but here that is used as a proverb. That used as a proverb because the Arabian people, they call dog as shaitan. And when they express their dislikeness towards someone, he said, look at him. His appearance is like shaitan. His appearance is, you got it? Now look. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired. You ask something and they came here in Quran. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, use the word shaitan for dog. You should write it. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he saw people of Arabia, they dare to worship dogs as their god. People in India, still they are doing the same thing. They worship monkeys. They worship cows. They worship snakes. They make their statues. They worship them alive and make their statues when they worship them. They do or not? Abhrasa? Yes, they do. So the people of Arabia, they used to worship dog and to prostrate in front of them and to make things of you. Got it? So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered to kill dogs. To kill. For two purposes. Number one, that you are worshipping them, that he is powerful, he can protect me. Dog is powerful, he can protect me. So Prophet ﷺ, by doing so, he gave them a message. He cannot protect himself, how he can protect you? He cannot defend himself, how he can defend you? Got it? Number one. And number two, when something has been ordered to be killed, so naturally dislikeness towards that thing will come into your mind. That there is something dislike. That there is something dislike. If I will ask Fahim, just say that thing, throw it out and break it. So what it means? Because I love it. I hate it. I dislike it. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave them such a message, so then they have in their mind a dislikeness towards God. Not to believe in them as their God. They are dogs, not God. They are DOGs, not DOD. Maybe they were wrong in spelling. Yes, they made dog as God. Got it? And later on, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as the people of Arabia, they used to believe in blade dog as the much more excellent powerful God. The blade God, which has the two yellow dots over his eyes. Have you ever seen such a dog? Yes, blade God having two yellow dots over his eyes. Here on his eyebrows, there are, and in Hadith Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, now start it. اُقْتُلُ الْأَسْوَدَ الْبَهِيمِ ذَنْ نُقْتَتِينَ فَإِنَّهُ شَيْطَانِ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, now you may kill only the black one having two yellow dots over his eyes and eyebrows. فَإِنَّهُ شَيْطَانِ, he is shaitan. Dead dog is shaitan. So now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called a special dog as shaitan. So here, that is used as a proverb.
إِنَّهَا شَجَرَةٌ إِنْتِهِدْ تِهِدْ شَجَرَةٌ إِتْرِي تَخْرُجُ وِجْ سَعُدْ سَعُدْ فِي أَسْتِي جَحِيمِ رَيْتِ دِبَاطَمَا فِي هَلْفَائِرْ تَلْغُهَا دِشُوتْ سَعْفِتْ فُرُوتْ سَعْدْ سَعْدْ
كأنه روح الشياطين لايجي أجبا شيطان فهو دي شيطان 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 but everybody hates شيطان even the non-Muslims. There are only there is only one specific group. In all time books they are called Sanaviyya. They are called Sanaviyya. But the reason was known by the name of Yazidi. So since that group exists there in Iraq and they are called Yazidiya. They are called Yazidiya. So they believe in two gods. They believe in two gods. In Allah which we believe that he is the giver of good. And they believe in Shaitan as God. And they worship Shaitan. They worship the otherwise. Everybody hates Shaitan. The Jews. They like Shaitan or hate him. The Christians. Yes. They. But anyhow, the Christians, they like Shaitan or they hate him. Yes, they hate him. The Hindus, the Sikhs, and everyone, they hate Shaitan. You know what I'm saying? But nobody has ever seen Shaitan. So either they dislike the concept, but nobody has ever seen the hands of Shaitan. So that's why we explain the ayah, كَأَنَّهُ رُوسُ شَيَاطِينَ, that if the fruit stalks are egg-headed and disliked and ugly, is the heads of dog. Is the heads of dog. And everybody has seen the dog head. Everybody has seen the dog head. So you will say, that all people here, they love dogs. They do not love their own kids, kick them out. But they love dogs, kissing them and licking them even. Not only kissing. What they do? They do lick them. But still, they dislike them. The same guy or the same lady, that she will become angry with someone because they're gonna lick. Yes, here she says, but it means that nature is to dislike dogs. Otherwise, why she says? Son of it? Yes. That should be a sentence to be said in time of love, that I love a man, son of it. Got it or not? So it means that in nature that dislikeness is. So that's why those who are licking dogs and they become angry, so they say, son of it. Huh? Yes, O.B. Yes. إنها شجرة تخرج في أصل الجحيم verily that is a tree تخرج which flowers out في أصل الجحيم right in the bottom of hellfire والغوها the fruits of its fruit stalk is كأنه رؤوس الشياطين like the heads of dogs فإنهم لآكلون منها truly they will eat thereof فمالئون منها البطون fill their bellies therewith ثم إن لهم عليها لشوبا من حميم and then on the top of there they will be given boiling water to drink and that will not be soft drinking water only boiling no that will be the pus and it is sharp of people in Jahannam outside Jahannam there is a big pond or a big reservoir where from the sweating the urine the excrement and the blood and the pus is coming out and it is boiling and after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them their soft drink then have it and Allah says يَتَجَرَّهُهُ they will drink it sick وَلَا يَكَادُوا سِيهُ but they will not be able to swallow it they will not be able to swallow it يَتَجَرَّهُهُ وَلَا يَكَادُوا سِيهُ وَيَاتِيهِ الْمَوْتُ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ وَمَا هُوَ بِمَيِّتٍ وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ عَذَابٌ وَعِنْدِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says only a single sip of their discharge, there is a message of death. But they there will never die. They will be living there forever and they will be facing the same azab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us far away from such like this. Say Ameen. Got it? So Allah says that when I said that death is a tree, which sprouts out right in the bottom of the burning fire. So the people are courageous. We say that Muhammad is not in his sense. He's a crazy man. He says things nobody can conceive even. Can you conceive? Can you imagine a tree sprouts out in the hellfire? Got it? Because their sight was very short. Their sight was, they were not short-sighted people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about another word. He's talking about another word, not about this word. God is Surah Bani Israel.
But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the night of Miraj and Ascension. And he came back. And he related the entire story to the people of Mecca. So on one hand, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was telling them the truth. But on the other hand, they were confused. In one night, he went why Medina and Kufa and through Al-Khalif in Palestine to Jerusalem and from Jerusalem to the heaven and upon the seventh heaven, met Allah there, came back the same night. Can you imagine? And that's why they were asking him, they said, have you seen the worship place here in Jerusalem? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, not only seen, I have led all the messengers and prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in spiritual way there in two rakat prayer. So now they ask him that how many doors are there in that worship place or in that masjid? So now look, we are coming, alhamdulillah, I am coming 5 times, sometime I come every day 7-8 times. Because I go to school and I take the parking lot and things like that. If you will ask me that, have you ever been in Granada Hill Masjid? Yes, brother, I go every day 10 times. How many doors are here? I don't know. Because I'm not here for the head purpose. Yes, to count the door and the windows and the glasses and things like that. You know what I'm saying? So Prophet ﷺ was not here to count the doors and the windows and the ventilation system. So Abu Jahl asked him, if you have seen the worship place there in Jerusalem, how many doors are there? For a while, Prophet ﷺ thought, oh, yeah, no. Jibreel came, don't worry. Don't. So Jibreel was showing him the picture of Bayt al-Maqdis. It was not seen to anybody else. Prophet ﷺ counted 1, 2, 3, 4. So they were the few teachers. Because they were aware of that Prophet before that has never been in Jerusalem. He has never been in Jerusalem. How many windows are here? So Prophet ﷺ looking at the picture, 10. How many ventilators are here? Prophet ﷺ, 12. Like this. The fans were there, so they asked, how many fans are there? 9. Got it. So then they asked him, that have you seen our caravan coming from Syria and from that area? Have you seen it? On your way towards Jerusalem, Prophet ﷺ said, yes, of course I have seen them in such a place. At such a set time. And they were staying here at night. And I drank a little bit water from their pitcher. And then I put the cup in such a way on their pitcher. You can confirm it from them. And Prophet ﷺ told them that let me give you another extra. That tomorrow at sunrise time, they will be coming down from that mountain. So now people were looking at that mountain at sunrise time and the caravan was coming down. So many people came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, Ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. But those who were confused about this whole story, that in one night or in a part of night, it happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was a test. That was it. Because that was beyond their intellectual approach. That was beyond their... So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as the night of ascension and Miraj, that is beyond their intellectual approach. Same is the case of the tree of the womb. That is beyond their intellectual approach. That is beyond their intellectual approach. But for Imam, that is not a must to approach it intellectually. But when Allah said something, believe it, I believe. When Prophet said something, I believe. That's not a matter of knowledge, that's a matter of belief. That's not a matter of knowledge, that's a matter of belief. Knowledge, you have to take it through your faith, your brain. But iman and faith, you have to take it through your heart. Yes, belief is here, knowledge is here. Regarding knowledge, you could be confused that somebody can create a doubt in your knowledge. But regarding belief, nobody will be able to approach your heart. So that's why you will be more than ready and prepared to sacrifice your life, even. Got it? So look into ayah number 60. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لَكَ, and remember when we told you, إِنَّ رَبَّكَ,
بیت بیرلی جو اللہ نفات بن لاتے ہی حیث ان کام و زمین کائنڈ مین they are in his grip they are in his grip and this grip is actually grace in Persian language that is grace
اِنَّ رَبَّكَ وَرِلِلُ وَاللَّهَ حَاطَ فِي النَّاسِهِ encompassed half surrounded people
from all around they cannot run away
وَمَا جَعَلْنَا الرُّعْيَا الَّتِي and we have not made the vision or the scene
رُعْيَا means scene S-C-E-N-T scene
وَمَا جَعَلْنَا and we have not made الرُّعْيَا الَّتِي they scene which we have shown you on the night of ascension إِلَّا فِتْنَةَ لِلنَّاسِ but this is a test for mankind
that is beyond your intellectual approach and number two
وَالشَّجَرَةَ الْمَلْعُونَةَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَالشَّجَرَةَ الْمَلْعُونَةَ آلُهَا إِنْ تَيْتْرِي الْمَلْعُونَةَ آلُهَا إِنْ تَيْتْرِي الْمَلْعُونَةَ آلُهَا Then the people who will eat it, they are the cursed people, they are also a test.
Because that is also beyond their intellectual approach. How a tree is grown and sprouted out here in the bottom of the burning hellfire. Got it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it is. And that is such a food that is, which has no any nutrition. There's only a punishment. No any nutrition. The more they eat, the more they will become hungry and they will be crying for food. Surah Al-Ghashiyah.
هل أتاك حديث الغاشية has there come to you O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث الغاشية the narration of the overwhelming
غاشية mean which can cover everything that tragedy or that event or that calamity which will cover everyone and everybody from all around that's their judgment
وجوه يومئذ some faces on that day will be خاشعتم in a humiliated way عاملتم laboring hard ناصبتم and tired تطلع نارا حامية they will enter in the hard blazing fire تطقى من غين عانية they will be given to drink from a boiling spring ليس لهم طعام no food will there be for them إلا من زريع but a poisonous thorny plant
that is the poop that is poisonous and it has thorns shawk in Arabic it's called shawk yes and what they call in Persian khar yes khardar what khardar
ليس لهم طعام إلا من زريع No food will there be for them illa min zari'in but a poisonous thorny plant. La yusminu wa la yughni min joo which will neither nourish nor avail against hunger.
Which will never nourish. Means it will not be providing them any what nutrition. And it will not take away their hunger but it will increase their hunger. It will increase your hunger so they will go back to your sabak.
إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُّومِ وَرِلِي جِكْرِيَا الزَّقُّومِ طُعَامُ الْأَثِيمِ will be the food of the sinner.
And by this sinner, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did mean the disbeliever. Because the extra ordinary major sin is the shirk and kufr. What? Shirk and kufr. So Athim means al-mushrik wal-kafir.
إن شجرة الزقوم indeed the tree of الزقوم الطعام العظيم the food of sinners كافر كالمولي like boiling filthy oil يغلي في البطون it will boil in the belly
that is such a thing when they will put it in their belly it will be boiling like filthy boiling oil like filthy boiling oil and now when we eat some oily food so then we say heart burning but hard burning and we are taking peptides and we are taking primates cryptobismol and things like that but there no such like things are available كالمول لايك بليك فلتي سيكي اويل يغلي في البطون it will be boiling in the belly كغلي الحميم لايك the boiling of a scalding water خذوه الله will say خذوه seize him فاصلوا and drag him الى ضوايا جحيم in the midst of the blazing fire not take him break him but break him خذوه كاتم فاصلوا and drag him الى ضوايا جحيم in the midst of the blazing fire ثم ضبوا فوقراته and then pour over his head من عذاب الحميم the torment of the boiling water ضب And Allah will say, or the angel will say, Zuk, test it. Zuk, from Gawk. Zuk, taste it. Innaka antal azizul kareem, verily you are pretending to be the mighty and the respectable one. In worldly life, you are pretending that you are a powerful guy and you are the respected guy. So now that the hospitality passes like people. Yes. ذوق كيف ان لك ورلي يو ور بريزنتين الغزيز تو بي ا مايتي جاي الكريم اند ريسبكتد وان ان هذا ورلي ذس از كنتم به تمترون وي ار اف يو يوز تو دو داون ان المتقين ورلي ذا فايز بيبل في مقام امين ذي ويل بي ان بليس اوف سكيورتي فيرنايز ا فيري سيف مقام امين مين ا فيري في جنات ان قاتل وعيون ان واتر سبرينج يلبسون من سندس they will be wearing من سندس وائز سبرك in fine silk and also in thick silk fine silk the soft one and thick silk here's the thick one sundus that is the soft one the sabrak the thick one يلبسون they will be wearing من سندس soft silk white sabrak and thick silk متقابلين and facing each other yes cushions are there couches are there sitting in front of each other yes making gupshup making what gupshup talking to each other yes tea is there food is there cheese kebab is there pizza is also there Munir will be making it يلبسون من سندس they will be wearing من سندس soft silk white sabrak and thick silk متقابلين facing each other كذلك it will be so وصومت now and he will marry them بحور عين he will marry them yeah وصومت now and he will marry them بحور عين The hur, that is for haur, and haur means whiteness. Haur means whiteness. So one meaning is that their eyes will be big. The haur and the whiteness of their white, so eyes will be big. Means their eyes will be big. And the second one, their complexion is white. Their complexion is white. وَضَوَّتْ now and we will marry them before and again with a whore with wide lovely eyes. Kareem means wide lovely eyes. Not only wide eyes. Wide lovely eyes. يَدْعُونَ فِيهَا بِكُلِّ فَاكِهَةٍ they will ask parents بِكُلِّ فَاكِهَةٍ for every kind of fruit. آمِنِينَ in peace and security. In peace and security means peace and security from everywhere and when they do ask from something they will never hear oh that is finished what that's finished we don't have more cheese kebab yes so should we bring you beef or chicken no Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says amineen whenever and wherever they will ask for things that is here yadhuuna fiha I think Khalid and Naseem will be in good shape يدعون فيها بكل فاكهة الآمنين yes they both think if marriage is not their only food is enough what do you think Khalid? يدعون فيها بكل فاكهة تبلكار ديرن فار ايوري كايند آف فروت آمنين ان فيس ان سكيورتي لا يذوقون فيها الموتى they will never taste this ديرن إلا الموتى الأولى except the first set and the first set of this world.
In Jannah there is no death. In Jahannam there is no death. In a hadith Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says when the people of Jannah would be taken to Jannah and the people of Jahannam, Jahannam to Jahannam, then an angel of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the death. It will be, this is an entity near Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we mentioned, that every spiritual thing in this world, it has a physical structure near Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every physical thing here, it has a spiritual model here, which is called Alamul Misal, our world of matter. That's called Alamul Misal upon the seven heavens, or what? World of Model. As you know, that Aristotle, he has written a very famous book. What is that?
Yes.
In Arabic, that is Al-Jumhuriyya. In English, that is translated in hundreds of languages. Yes. And so in English, that is translated as the Republic. That's written by who? By Aristotle, the Republic. That's a famous book. And here, he has given the concept of a true republic.
Of a
true republic. But the way he spoke about a true republic state, or democratic state, republic state, or democratic state, there is freedom, there is justice, there is providing of every need to every single individual, even to the animals. You know what I'm saying? So later on, he said, that if such like a Jamhuriya or Republic does not exist in this world, so for sure, in world of matter, Allah has a model of this state with him. Right? Got it? Now when Aristotle, he was not a Muslim. Was he? He was not a Muslim. But now this concept that is there in his mind as well. And Imam Waliullah, rahimahullah, in his famous book, Hujjatullah al-Baligha, he has written a specific chapter by the name of, or by the words of Baba Maja'a fi Alam al-Misal, World of Matter.
World of
Matter.
Got it?
So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the angel will bring the death in shape of a big rain, not lamb.
In shape of a big rain, having two big horns.
And the angel will bring that death to the height of A'raf.
To the height of
A'raf. A'raf is a place in between Jahannam and Jannah. Paradise and hellfire. There is a place which is called A'raf. And in Holy Quran, there is a specific surah by the name of Surah A'raf. وَعَلَى الْأَعْرَافِ رِجَالٌ يَعْرِفُونَ كُلًّا بِسِيمَاهُمْ. And then that such a place, where from the people of A'raf, they can see crystal clear the Jahannam and the Jannah both. To their right, they will look at the people in Jannah. And to their left, the people in Jahannam. Got it? So that is a high place. To that height, the angel will bring the death in shape of the rain. And the angel will call upon the people of Jannah and Jahannam both. That all the people of Jannah, Ya Ahl al-Jannah, look at me. Wa Ya Ahl al-Nar, look at me. For the people in Jahannam and the people in Jannah, look at me. This is your death.
This is
your death. People living in their courts where from you have come already. So if somebody was in good shape, he was a king, a ruler, a billionaire, big business, happy life, wife, children, friends, servants, and so on and so on. Different type of ride, car, BMW, without accident.
Yes.
Everything was there. Everything was.
But still, he was thinking, oh, if the death will come, everything is gone.
If the death will come, and the death will approach me, I will lose everything. I will. There was a fear of that concept like guy. And there were people who were in stress and distress. How to use ATM?
Yes.
In stress and distress, in confusion, in trouble, in such like calamities and tragedies, that they were willing and wishing death for themselves. And that's why sometimes they do commit suicide. Sometimes people do commit suicide, they kill themselves because they are in stress. They are in distress. They are in tension. So they are looking for death. So now the people in Jannah, they are in happy form. And the people of fire, they are in stress and distress, in grief and worry, in punishment and torment. So the people of Jannah, maybe they will be having the fear of death. If death will approach us, we will lose all these blessings and power. And the people of Jahannam, they will be looking for death. وَقَالُوا يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكَ قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. In Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the people in Jahannam, they will ask the chief supervisor or the chief superintendent of hellfire, his name is Malik, that, oh Malik, can you please forward our application to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of death to get rid of this situation? So Malik will tell them, innakum maqidun, you will never die, you will be living here forever in such like situation. Got it? So they will be living for death, and the people in Jannah, they will be having a fear of death. That if the death will approach us, we will lose all these things. So the angel will tell both of them, look at me. And then he will take a knife in his hand and slaughter their brain. It will slaughter their brain. And the angel will tell the people in Jannah, Ya Ahl al-Jannah, khuludun wala maut. Stay and live forever. There is no any fear of death. Wa ya Ahl al-Nar, khuludun wala maut. And all people in the hellfire, live here forever. No death to get rid of this situation. So that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said.
La yadukuna fiha, they will never taste fiha in their Jannah. Al-mawta, any death, illa al-mawta al-hula, but only their death with their face already
in their worldly life.
وَوَقَعُوا عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمُ. And Allah will save them from the torment of the blazing fire. فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكَ, as a bounty from your Lord. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ, this will be the supreme success. فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ, certainly we have made this Quran very easy in your tongue, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
So as I mentioned before, and you should write it, that
none of the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever committed sin. Because a messenger has to be a role model for humanity. And a role model must be a perfect personality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved them from any type of sin even before message. And that's why every messenger presented his personal life to people when he was giving message for the first time. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was giving message for the first time on the Mount of Safa, so he asked people, وَقَدْ لَبِثْتُ فِيكُمْ غُمُرًا مِّنْ قَبْلِهِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. I have spent amongst you 40 years of my life. You have seen my childhood, when I was a young boy, a teenager, then when I attained the age of puberty, when I was a young jawan, having all my physical power, up to 40 years, have you ever seen me doing something wrong? Telling lies? Cheating someone? Harming someone for no reason? Can you tell me even one single story in this regard? One single event or one single word in this regard? أَلْبَجَتْتُمُونِي صَادِقًا أَمْ كَاذِبًا. Have you found me as a truthful person? Or I have told lies even once in my lifetime. So what all of them said? مَا وَجَتْنَا فِيكَ إِلَّا سِسْتًا جَرَّبْنَاكَ مِرَارًا. We have experienced from you only truth and honesty. Got it? So now when they confirmed and approved his personality and personal life, having no stain on his personal life, so then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that if I will tell you that an enemy is very much close to attack you from behind the Mount of Abu Qubais, from behind the Mount of Abu Qubais, will you believe in this news of mine? So they say, of course, because you never told any lie in your lifetime in these 40 years. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them,
Their pythons are standing behind Jabariya Hukumay. At that time, also Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was not telling lies. That python, he is standing behind the mount of Abu Qubays, and he is taking you to take you to the hellfire. And he is a very arch enemy of yours. So just say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. You will get into success and you will get rid of your enemy. That's a protection for you from the enemy of yours. So now they oppose him and they rejected his message. But anyhow, they never said anything about Rasulullah. Even though sometimes for their blind spot or for their political purpose, they were saying about Rasulullah saying crazy. He is madman. He does not have sense. He is a falsifier. He is a liar. He is a poet. He is a soothsayer. He is so and so and so and so. He has all these things, but still they were putting their trust property with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were not believing in anybody else. Yes, my money, my gold, my jewelry. They put it in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were not believing in his message. But when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was migrating to Medina, why he left behind Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala for 3 days and nights to return the trust property of the people of Makkah, his enemies. I have trust properties of people. Gold is there, diamonds are there, jewelry is there, rubies are there, money is there, so and so. So you have to give it back to the people concerned. Got it? That's how the personality of a messenger is. Regarding Prophet Musa, alayhi salatu wa salam, Allah said, وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي. I have made you, O Musa, for myself. So now, if the Toyota owner, he will be making a Toyota car for himself, what type of Toyota that will be? Much more better than Mercedes even. Yes? That will be a perfect Toyota. Yes, like that of professor. Toyota Camry. That's a perfect one. Yes, that is. So anyhow, if the owner is making something for his own self, so what type of thing he will make? Say, a perfect one. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa alayhi salam, وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي, I have made you for myself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِتُسْنَا عَلَىٰ غَيْنِي, so you may be grown under my surveillance or under my supervision. وَلِتُسْنَا, and that was the case of every single messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فَإِنَّمَا يَصْبَرْنَاهُ بِلِسْعَانِكَ,
so no any messenger has ever committed anything. Yes, sometimes mistake happens from messenger. Mistake is something else. Mistake happens by way of accident. By way of accident it happens, that's not a sin. We call it khata. We call it what? Khata. There is a big difference between sin and mistake. Got it? Mistake is pardon, and sin would be considered next time.
فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ, certainly we have made this Quran easy in your tongue.
So now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometimes he did mistake in his prayer even. As Imam Malik rahimahullah narrated a hadith that in Salat al-Zuhr, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made salam after 2 rakats. After, he was supposed to make it after 4 rakats, but he made salam after 2 rakats. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. He forgot that I have prayed 2 rakats or 4. So he made salam. So one sahabi, all sahaba rizwanullah alayhim ajma'in, they were sitting because of adab, because of respect, calm and quiet. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was receiving message. And certain things were going on today, and tomorrow it was abrogated. Tomorrow it was abrogated. So they were thinking, maybe the change has taken place. Now we have to pray only 2 rakats afterward. So that's why all sahaba rizwanullah alayhim ajma'in, they were sitting calm and quiet. One sahabi radiallahu ta'ala an, he had come from Sahara, from Damascus. Yes, I mean a simple name. So he was sitting here. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made salam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, أَقُفِرَ فِي الصَّلَاةِ أَمْ نَسِيْتَ, you forgot our prayer is shortened. You forgot our prayer is shortened. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Sahaba, أَصَدَقَ بُلْيَدَيْنِ, you are a tall man. You are a tall man. And as you know, that a man who is a tall one, his legs are tall, and his hands are tall as red. His fingers are big, you know. So then, he was a tall man, so that's why Rasulullah said, a sadaqatu al-yadain, the guy who has two long hands, he's speaking the truth, in here, okay, see, I say, two rakat or four rakat, a sadaqatu al-yadain, so Sahaba confirmed it, yes sir, you prayed only two rakat and you made the salam of it. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam stood up and he prayed it. You know, so that was a mistake. And if Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would not have did it, that subhanAllah, so there would have been no any room for mistake in your prayer. And we are human beings. We are human beings, we are making mistakes. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an enough room that if somebody will make mistakes, so there will be enemies. Tell me what?
فإنما يسرناه بلسانك indeed we have made it easy by your time لعلهم يتذكرون in order that they may understand what you are saying for nothing so wait O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم إنهم مرتكبون verily they are waiting to for the decision of Allah
سبحانه وتعالى الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين، اللهم ربنا اشرح لنا بالقرآن العظيم لما ذكرنا بالقرآن ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جعلنا وصلاة وأطعمنا الليل وأنا النهار صلى الله وسلم حافظا